Our seismic network here at the Montana Bureau of Mines and Geology recorded a magnitude 5.8 earthquake early this morning, about 12:30 a.m. It was felt throughout western Montana, up into southern Canada, down into eastern Idaho and Yellowstone, and from Spokane eastward to at least Lewistown, Montana.
Now, from what I understand, Mike, from some of the reading I've done, this was what is termed a rather shallow quake. What does that mean?
Well, the depth of the rupture that caused this earthquake is about 15 kilometers or 9 miles below the surface of the earth. And so there was a fracture down there, a fault, that where some slippage occurred, and that's what resulted in this earthquake. 15 kilometers is not a unusual depth. It's kind of towards the deep end of what we see for most seismicity in Montana. It's unusual to get things much deeper than 16 or 20 kilometers below the surface. So, but it's still in the upper part of the crust. So really almost all of our seismicity in this part of the country is relatively shallow, as this earthquake was.
Sure. As far as you know, this was in a rather remote place. Was there any damage or injuries reported?
Well, I have not been in contact with any of the authorities that might have inspected the areas. I have heard that there's some minor damage in Helena and also a few bricks down from an older building here in Butte. But I really don't have any outside information on damage at this point. I understand from some of the news crews who have been here earlier, they have crews that are going up into the Lincoln and Helena area, and we'll learn more in the near future.
Sure. Now, from what I understand, the discussions I've had with you in over the last couple of years, this area is rather prone to earthquakes, is it not?
It absolutely is. This earthquake occurred squarely within the Intermountain Seismic Belt that runs through western Montana, roughly between Kalispell and Yellowstone Park, and the Lincoln area is more or less the middle of that zone. We've seen small earthquakes, small and moderate earthquakes there through the years as we've monitored earthquake activity around the state, and so in that respect, it's not a huge surprise that a significant earthquake would occur in this area.
Well, now, from what I understand, that there was the initial quake and then several aftershocks. That also is normal, right?
Yes, for a quake of this size, when there are smaller earthquakes that are triggered by the initial shock, and so far, the largest aftershock has been is a magnitude 4.9 that occurred about 5 minutes after the main shock, and then there was a magnitude 4.5 that was not quite an hour later, and we've seen so far 15 aftershocks in the magnitude 3 to 4 range, and literally hundreds of aftershocks smaller than that.
So how long will this continue, Mike?
Well, there's no way to predict, but I would expect that there will be at least small earthquakes occurring in this area for months to come, possibly years. And I'll emphasize those are the smaller events, but it would not be surprising if we get additional earthquakes that are large enough for nearby residents to feel.